What's your favorite level type?
My favorite or my fucking favorite?
Your fucking favorite.
I've hacked into the transporter that goes directly to the bridge. Take
I
that up
don't
to the top
know.
level.
Well, I hope it's elevator because it's an elevator level.
Damn it! I was hoping it was gonna be a sliding block puzzle!
I mean, I was gonna say good one, but this is. No.
Welcome to a very fancy looking level, though.
This is pretty fancy looking.
It does actually look nice, shit.
There he is!
Also, hey, it's old friends. Remember all those armors we saw in the cutscene?
No, I didn't have video during that point.
No, don't spoil it!
It's already happened! You can't go back!
Anyway, now instead of being chased by three assholes, we're being just like surrounded by three assholes.
Being lightly harassed by three assholes.
Like, they're basically three giant blue mosquitoes.
Can you fall off?
No. There's an invisible wall saving you for, like, thank god. This game doesn't have a deaths.
Yeah, this game is generally not a dick, it seems. Just surprising.
You say that.
I said generally. Episode, I said generally. Don't give me that.
This episode is gonna be a bit special.
Oh,
it's a very
really?
Special episode, yeah.
Special or special?
You'll see. Anyway, here's three more guys.
You're gonna pay for what you did to their buddies.
Yeah.
Their buddies, not their comrades or fellow soldiers or friends, their buddies.
Okay, but what about their pals?
Well, their buddies are not their pals.
What is even the distinction? I'm curious.
A buddy is someone you constantly hang out with, but a pal is someone you see rarely, but have the same kind of relationship as with a buddy.
We can't lose to this guy!
Okay, if you insist.
Sure, whatever. I'll take it!
I mean, my culture has very finesse distinctions between various levels of affection, so yeah. I don't know what you Westerners.
Well, see, here, when you refer to someone as your pal, it generally means you're about to shank them.
Well, that depends on the intonation. But anyway, these people... This level is basically the same 80% around. So it's gonna be a lot of... blue assholes flying around killing us.
No, I'm enjoying the repetition. This is good. This is... yeah. Delicious.
How fucking big is this ship? Or whatever the fuck it is we're on.
Wasn't it like the size of a country?
It's the size of a continent, actually.
Ah, shit. Close enough.
So they can basically make levels as long as they want. It'll still make canonical sense.
Getting horribly harassed by orb. This is beautiful.
The orbs are terrible.
They're fucking your day up.
So fun trivia bit. If you had the non-first print European version of this game, it would lock up after you beat this level.
Wait, what?
Oh, wow.
Yeah, basically all discs that weren't first print lock up after this level in Europe. They had like an issue with manufacturing, and that's just the state of things.
Wow.
And that's why the first LP got cancelled, because that happened.
Oh, okay. Good. That's good. I like that. That's good.
It's particularly terrible because this is one of the hardest fights in the game. The boss fight for this level.
I just more appreciate that their guns are basically pea shooters, and it's the orbs that fuck you up, of all things.
Like, that orb technology is really strong.
You don't fuck with a man and his orbs, okay?
What's wrong?
Orbs will fuck
I'm
you
not
up.
At the top level yet.
I've lost control due to enemy intervention.
No, not
Stand
enemy intervention.
They
online.
Pulled the plug on the computer, Utah! I don't know what happened!
Utah, my hacking is ineffective again! So this is basically the, oh god, you might need some help when you fight the same boss three times. There's really, there's not actually a point in breaking them aside from points, because this is actually time-based, it's not, waiting until you kill everyone.
I still don't understand what determines if a fire hurts you or not. It's beyond me.
Yeah, it's random.
No, that's good. I love me some RNG.
It's to make speedrunning this the harder.
Like, I'm sure it's not random, but I'll be fucked if I can understand it.
It's... Like, I've generally figured out how this game does some stuff, and it does a lot of weird shit, which you'll see later on as well. But I have not found the fire thing. Online.
So, Bear, when are you gonna give us your sweet speedrun strats? This is a speedrun.
Well, here's one strat.
My god!
To upgrade your range.
So intense. Man, they were really fucking proud of this elevator and the little background they got going.
And the blue assholes.
I mean, it is a really good background.
Oh, it is! It's sweet as hell, but they were very clearly very proud of it.
Well, you know, considering that you're just in one fucking elevator, at least they made the effort to make it look pretty.
Also, what is it the glow sticks on their jetpacks anyway?
The glow sticks create electricity between them, and that's what spawns the orbs.
Oh, I thought they were just for, you know, a sweet robot rave.
They're for both.
Yeah, like, it's not mutually exclusive. This way. We can't lose to
this guy! My dad, I'm glad they all have the same voice.
Well, but they're like stormtroopers, they're all clones of each other.
You know, I doubt that, but sure.
They're also giant assholes because they keep doing that stupid shoot and run thing.
Also, how fucking many of them do they have just to send to their death?
I think this is the last batch after this boss. I think they realized that maybe four waves of this would have been too much.
Colonel, I'm sorry.
Oh, I love the voice acting in this.
Really just sold me on that line.
It's amazing. It's a giant blue asshole.
Oh, what the Christ. All of his men. I don't care. But one thing is certain. You're the most powerful warrior I've ever met.
All right, this is the final battle. Let's get on with it. Who writes this dialogue?
So this is the Limping Colonel. So, let me explain how to kill the Limping Colonel, the giant mech. You cannot reach him with your bombs. And when... when he does these yo-yos, you basically have to stack bombs, wait for his shield to go down, and then detonate them.
That's actually kind of cool.
Yeah. And after I remembered it was this boss fight, I considered raising my shield, but... yeah. Let's see how far I can go with just three levels of shield. The problem is, like, if I lower my bomb count, it'll make... this a bit more unbearable to do because it takes longer to kill him. Also, the buzz saws do an insane amount of damage. I think they do like a tenth of your health bar.
Jesus.
Look, you don't fuck with a man in his yo-yos, okay?
The more you damage him, the more shit goes out as you yo-yo. So at this phase, he's alternating between homing lasers and rockets.
And his magical yo-yos.
The yo-yos always come out.
His sweet fucking laser yo-yos.
So as you see, there is more and more shit coming out.
And somehow you're more accurate with the bombs. I don't understand.
Is this really the end?
Yes, please, let it be.
Roger that.
Damn it.
We're going back out.
Fucking damn it. No.
So, in the previous LP, which is now Lost to the Void, me trying to beat this boss was around 40 minutes. Like, it was sped up first, but it was me, like, fighting him for 40 minutes till I killed him, because it's really hard to dodge everything. Because the less health he has, the more stuff he does at once. So at one point you reach a phase where he is doing lasers, rockets, and yo-yos at once.
Nice.
Look, that is a sweet-ass robot, okay?
It's a really good robot.
It's a really fucking good robot.
I mean, I fucking want, like, green laser yo-yos.
But yeah, I didn't do damage that time because I detonated them before he lowered his yellow shield thing.
Oh my god.
Yep.
This is kind of awful.
It's like, it's an interesting fight. It's just like a massive difficulty spike compared to literally everything else in the game.
No, I just don't care for bosses that are waiting games, honestly.
Well, he never skips, like, a yo-yo phase, so it's not really that much waiting. It's not as bad as, the boat level.
Oh god, shut up.
Oh god, the boat level.
It had so much potential, but then it blew it out its ass.
So yeah, this part is the hardest because, those rockets will interrupt you from, setting bombs. And until you recover from the rocket hit, you cannot actually detonate your bombs, so he might actually eat them up before you detonate them.
Or he'll just completely fuck you up like that.
Yeah.
This is a clusterfuck of a fight.
I know, that's why it's great.
I think, like, the worst part is the fear of hitting the yo-yos while dodging everything, because the yo-yos do the most damage.
Also, half the time they're off screen.
Their direction kind of depends on your position on the field.
Oh man, that slowdown! Holy shit!
Is this really the end?
I seem to have not cut out one
Roger
death.
That.
It was actually supposed to be the winning attempt after this one, the first one. Okay.
Uh huh.
Sure. You say so.
Look, editing is hard.
Yeah, sure.
But we'll just say I kept that in to illustrate how difficult this fight is.
Mm-hmm. Sure.
And to illustrate how helpful checkpointing in front of bosses is from a game design perspective, please do that for all your games. Man, that was like two or three loops and we already have half of his health down, which is pretty insane. Like, the damage scaling from higher bomb stack is like really big.
You were getting like reliably high stacks. And then you started getting shot at, and it all went to hell.
There is kind of a way to, for some bosses, you can kind of skip these pimped up phases by doing enough damage to just like have health skip over it. Because the way they attack depends on their health bar.
Okay.
So say if you were to do like 8 stacks, you could maybe like skip one of these loops. Or you know, if you do like little damage and then just do a big chunk to skip.
Yeah, I was gonna say, just do a little bit by bit to get to a threshold, and then skip.
Yeah.
A fitting end for one who lives on the field of battle.
Dude, you're working
insane.
He was working private security for this ship. I don't know what he means by on the field of battle.
That elevator, clearly. This is just their average Saturday afternoon
level.
In the elevator.
The bridge is just ahead.
That was a good run.
What the?
Utah, what's wrong?
Benoit.
I thought I would save you the trouble and effort by ordering the test subject to deal with them.
The test subject? You're talking about that bioweapon creature in the research facility, aren't
you? Is Benoit's gauntlet somehow larger than Utah's?
What in the world are you...
Be silent.
He has more to compensate for.
This I say, Benoit, I didn't know your gauntlet was so large.
Utah now. Well, shall we get this party underway?
The best part about being even longer is that clips through him so fucking much.
I know.
And every crew member will die.
Wow. That's dramatic.
The Dante is an autonomous
such an edgelord. It's
capable
great.
Of making its own decisions and carrying out its missions. However, control of the AI was unstable, therefore it had to be locked down. But I seized the opportunity to release it and did so by altering the master code.
The master code!
This was your twisted plan all along?
Yes, that's correct. Brain, the autonomous program, takes priority over all control systems. What that means is, if you control Brain, you control the entire Dante. One person can do it. Not only the ship's operations, but all of her unmanned weapons are under my control.
I see. Then the reason our surprise raid failed is because you leaked information out to the enemy.
A decoy was necessary until I could take command of the Brain. At the same time, it was an exercise for you.
What are you talking about?
It was an exercise intended to awaken you. Why don't you just admit it?
Could have given them coffee, you know.
Admit that you only feel life is worth living when you're killing on the battlefield.
Benoit, please don't tell me about how the only way you can get off is by killing a man. I don't need this.
Natural born slayer?
This is so
freaking
painful.
No, Utah! He's wrong! Don't listen to him! You're not some kind of fighting organism!
Shut up!
Lady, that's literally what he is, actually!
You told me that I had only to give you the order if there was something I wanted to save or protect. I bet there's something that you
want. Wasn't he actually just genetically engineered to be a soldier?
Even if he lost sight of it now.
Yes.
Yeah, exactly! He's literally a living weapon!
Your soul isn't empty, Utah! Don't let Benoit convince you otherwise!
This is just...
Shut up! Shut up! Shut up! What could you possibly know about him?
Actually, a lot
more
than you, Benoit.
Utah,
she's actually talked to him.
With me.
Together, you and I will use the Dante's power to plunge the world into sheer chaos and panic!
Is he proposing to Utah?
I won't claim
that
it's right.
Shit.
I'm not interested in who I am. But one thing is extremely clear to me. I have a duty here to perform, and that duty is to destroy the Dante.
That's right, Utah.
The negotiations have broken down, hmm?
There were no negotiations, Benoit, what the fuck?
Too bad, Utah.
I think he really was proposing to him.
Momentarily.
Yeah, he kinda was, actually.
He really was.
Proof that this was a manned vessel.
That's why he had such a large gauntlet. He was trying to show off for Utah.
Signal on the bridge.
That's not a gauntlet! It's an engagement ring!
Utah,
he was basically
up,
peacocking.
Utah!
Oh, shit!
Well, Utah's dead.
Oh wow, what a shame. Game over.
Game over, bad that you didn't accept Benoit's proposal.
Nope, it's fine, don't worry about it.
You better be grateful, Utah. We
yes!
To rescue you.
The best character.
Quiet, Tim. Never Tim behind.
I fucking love Tim. I love everything about Tim.
What's with that look on your face? Get a grip, Utah.
I love that John losses every line just shutting Tim up.
My favorite part about Tim is that he doesn't actually seem to understand, like, what the fuck is going on. Yes! What the fuck is going on, so he's just so stupidly cheerful about it.
I know.
But did he get the D?
I mean, you did. You clearly got the D.